Hello and a very warm welcome to the webinar series of Manu Patra. My name is Chandrasekhar Patil. Today's webinar topic, a very interesting and unique one, which talks about the common mistakes users make while researching on manupatra.com. So I will showcase the various common mistakes you do from the time you log in to log off. So let me start with the first topic in this. So to start with, the first topic what I am covering here is, usually we have a habit of opening the browser and going to Google to open any website. So that is what we do usually, and sometimes you end up in a page. So let me open Google. So we usually type Google manupatra.com here and click on search. So see, there you get various pages. The second page what you are getting here is a IP access page. This is for the IP customers, and you do not have a user ID password here. So you might get confused. Sometimes you also get mobile.manupatra.com or .in. So do not go and type in Google. Instead, type manupatra.com in the section given on the top. Click on enter. You might go to the, once you click on manupatra.com, the URL might change to manupatrafast.com or manupatra.in, depending on the server traffic. So this is the first mistake what users usually do. So avoid this. The second thing what point I am covering here is, when users put in their login credentials and click on sign in, they do a double click. So at your first click, the login would have happened, and the second click it will show you a message that the session is active. So that would create a problem to you. You can't log in for the next 10 minutes. Usually you are in a hurry to do your research and you want results immediately, and that 10 minutes could be too costly for you. So do not double click on go. Just do a single click, you'll log in. The third point is, as you all know, Manupatra uses natural language processing. So what is natural language processing? In natural language, you type your queries and you do not have to use Boolean parameters like and, or, not, and all those things. So that is one of the best way to do your research. So I'll just show you an example here. So I've done a search in Manu search, and the paragraph which I have shown below is the paragraph which is relevant in the judgment. So let us do this search and see in Manupatra. So I click on Manu Search. I type this query here and click on search. So I get the results. So if you scroll down, the words you have searched for will be highlighted. So this is a paragraph what I showed, paragraph 24, which is a relevant paragraph, culpable homicide and section 304 of IPC. Both are being captured here. So whatever you search, as per the relevance, it gives you the results. So you can use natural language and you can also use Boolean parameters. That is also recognized in Manu Search. Do not frame long sentences or questions. One of the examples what I have given here is, under what circumstances bail can be given under section 354 of IPC. When I did a search, I'll show you this example. So I did not get any results. So you can see, I made a search, I could not get any results. The same search can be done in a very simple way, where I put IPC 354 bail granted in a query. So that would get you the results. So you can see you have got 97 judgments. So these are the relevant results as per your query. So do not frame long sentences or questions to search. Search with only keywords. Try not to use noise words like it, of, with, etc. Use proximity option for relevant results. The same point I have covered, and the another example what I am showing here is, child born to surrogate mother from foreign national father can get Indian citizenship. This is what you want to know. So do not put this as a query in Manu Search, and also do not use quotes against single word. You have to use it as a phrase, and when you are using the quotes between two sentences, leave a space in between. So let me show you this example. So I want these words to be searched. So I have got the relevant judgment. So you can see I have used foreign national in quotes, but not father. That is because you can see biological father is a foreign national. See, father and foreign national is not coming together. So I have split that single word separately. So you need to use quotes for words which you want together and leave out words other than that in a separate individual word. So this is a relevant judgment. So let me go to the next point here. We suggest you do not search for the following field queries in Manu search. That is appellant or respondent. Do not type a party name in a Manu search and search. Do not search for citation in Manu search. Do not search for judgment under act and section. Do not search for a bare act in Manu search. So what will happen when you do this searches in Manu search? It will give you, like, for example, party name. I say United Breweries. So it will give you all judgments where the United Breweries word is used across judgments. Where the judgment is referred, it will show you that also. Even the same thing with citation. It will show you that citation where all that is referred. So we suggest you to avoid this. You can continue doing these in Manu search. Like, you want to search for judgments with keywords, you want to search for a Bayer Act, you want to search for rules and regulations, any other part of Manu Patra. So I'll just show you an example in notifications and circulars. Let me type this query. So I go to Manu search. I type this query. I want the results only from notifications and circulars. So just select that database and click on search. So I am getting the most relevant notifications on the top. So this is how you make a search and still get results, relevant results in Manu search. So you can try out all other examples, you'll still get the relevant results. So another topic what usually customers do is they put versus in between the parties and search. So when you're searching for parties, do not search, do not put versus and search, and also uncheck this. This is another point which I would be showing in the next slides. You do not get the result. So type it without the versus in between. And you can type both the parties. It's not that you type only appellant or respondent. Both can be typed and you'll get the relevant results. So on the top you can see those judgments coming up. So avoid this point as well. Let me show you how do you do a citation search. If you have to avoid doing it in Manu search, where do I do it? So you have a citation search thing. I want to search for Madras Law Journal. The citation is, here is 2019, volume 8. Page number 117, and the judgment is from Madras High Court. So select that and click on search. Let me do that again. So you get the judgment. You can see the citation, equivalent citation there. So this is how you search for Manu Patra citation. Let me also show you a Manu citation. So just select Manu, select the year. We don't have a volume, so you don't have to type that. So different publishers have different style of doing this. And I select Supreme Court and click on search. So I get the relevant judgment. So this is how you search for Manupatra citation. And as I already mentioned, if you search Manu citation or any other citation in Manu search, you will get all judgments where that particular citation is referred. Another point what most of you might think is Manupatra changes the paragraph numbers of the judgment. Manupatra does not divide paragraphs of original judgment, which changes the paragraph numbering. You can see an example given here. On the top, what I am showing the paragraph is of Manupatra, and down I have shown you the same paragraph from the Judis site, which is a court site. So the paragraph numbering is the same. So you can see the same paragraph is cited in one judgment of Orissa High Court. There it is referred from SEC citation. The paragraph numbering there is 36. What SEC has done is they have split various paragraphs and changed the numbering. So what happens if someone tells you refer this and this judgment and this paragraph? If you are referring a different database, you might end up having a look at a different paragraph altogether. So when you are referring these kind of citations, be very particular to see the main judgment, how the paragraph numbering is done. SEC would have changed the paragraph numbering. So avoid that mistake. So another point what most of the customers do mistaken. In legal search, we have two options to search. One is judgment under act and section. That will give you a judgment. That will not give you a bare act. And reading a act and section is a different option. So I have shown you this. On the top, what you see is for act, and here it is for the judgment under bare act. Let me show you this example. I want to search for IPC 354. You can use these abbreviations and for. I get the relevant judgments on 354. If I want to view the act, then I click on act search. I type IPC. I get a drop down here. Select that drop down. Select the section. Section 354 and click on search. You directly go to that section. And if you want to view the complete act, click on this page icon. You'll get the complete act. This also is covered in one of the next slides, but from a different way, how do I open the full text of the judgment? Do not click on this. This would take you to the complete list of acts. This is the page icon. This is a different icon. Did you know you can open judgments in a new window? Most of the customers have a habit of opening the judgment in the same window by clicking on the title. So instead of that, you can click on the window icon next to the search result and go for let me show you the same attachment. Okay, let me do a search and go back to the results. So this is a window icon what I am talking about. So click on this. You can open multiple windows and flip between each other without disturbing the results. So another confusion what customers have is add to session and new window icon. Add to session is for adding the judgment or shortlisting the judgment to read, email, print and save during the current session. So basically you find one judgment relevant and then when you find below the search result you find another judgment, keep adding those to the add to session list. After that you have to go to the session list before sign off. If you sign off you lose those judgments if you have not saved it. So do not log out without going to the session list. So let me show you an example. I click on add to session. I have clicked on another judgment. Then I have clicked on three judgments. So before sign off, go to session list. Out of these, I want all judgments. I can select all and email. All will be emailed to you at one shot. You want to save all three, you can do that. You want to print, you can do that. Or you want to do only two of these, you can do that. So this is the session list from where you get the add to session saved judgments. So another topic, another point what we are covering here is timeline authority check icon and overruled icon. The green radio button icon in the search result is for timeline authority check and not a sign off good judgment. So few customers mistake it as a green icon. This shows it is a good judgment and a red color flag which is there for overruled judgments. It's an indication of overruled judgments. So when you click on that red color flag mark, let me show you the example and explain you there. So I will search for Konkan Railway and Rani Construction judgment, which is a overruled judgment. You can see I've got the result and this icon is for a graph which would show you all the judgments where Konkan Railway and Rani Construction has been referred and how it is treated. And this red color flag, if you click on that, it will take you to the judgment which has overruled this judgment. So both these icons are different and denote two different things. It's not a good judgment as I mentioned you. So another point what I am covering here is which usually customers do a mistake. In the search result, you have save search and set alert. If you click on save search, you can save this judgment, save this search result. So let me save it with any number, or you can give anything you can remember with. From here, you have to go to manage search. So in manage search, you'll have that query. So on the top, once you have that search, you have to type in your email ID, number of days you want to get the alerts. basically what it does is it saves your query and you don't have to repeat that search again and again. So from that particular moment, any other judgment uploaded on Manupatra on the same query, we will send you an alert on your email ID mentioned. So it will help you be updated on the same query. So you don't have to repeat that search. Then another point is always download the judgment from the PDF version given on the judgment page. You have the icon, PDF icon there. Click on that and save or download. Let me show you an example. So I open it in a additional window. I have this PDF icon here. Click on that. You have an option to open it with or without the headnote. Click on the print icon. The PDF would open here. It would not print, but it is initially opening the judgment copy. You can download or print from here. You can download to your desktop from here. Do not print the judgment from the web page. Like I open the judgment in the same window. Do not go to the print option here and print. It will give you a web page printout, but not the judgment printout. So this is one of the things which you should avoid. And we have another option of print replica. Courts accept judicial judgments, so copy of which is available in the print replica given here. See, click on that. Click on the journal and you get the judicial copy of the same judgment. You can take a printout of the same and present in the court. So these are the options to print and save. So one of the most oldest, I should say, queries what we have from customers: how do I go back to the results page from the search result? So we have three options for that. One is, let me show you in the page itself. One is from the go to search results. Second is given at the top, the results icon. It will take you to the last search result. And the third is, if you have scrolled down, you also have a floating bar. You can go back through that. So these are the three options to go back to your search results if you have opened the judgment in the same window. So another query what usually customers have is, I have selected by mistake some, I want to open some particular database. People usually tend to select this instead of clicking on the table of contents. So if I do a search without unchecking that, see, I select this, I don't get any results. So do not check any content and make a search if you are not wanting to search only from that particular database. So usually view that if you are not getting results, you might have checked some table of contents and you might not get the results. Apart from judgments, all other TOC contents can be viewed by clicking on the plus sign and table of contents. till the judgments in the table of contents, you can't view any of the content till international database. You can't view any of the contents. From here onwards, you can click on any of these pages and that can be opened. But you can't click on this. I want to see judgments of 2020. I can't view that. But instead, you can go to legal search, set a range from January 1st till now. You want to see the search results, you will get that. So you have that option to do. But you can't click on table of contents and view those results. So as I showed you in the search part, you can click on the page icon. When I search for a particular act, you can click on the page icon. So let me show that in their acts also. So I click on alphabetical order. I want to search and open Negotiable Instrument Act. I can do a Control F here. So I get the act here. I have a page icon in front of that. So the complete act opens in a single doc. And you can take a printout of this. You can save this. All that can be done from here. So to view the act in a single doc, you do that. But if you open the act and then click on any section, it would open only that section. It will not give you all sections in a single doc. So this is the common mistake what users do. So avoid this particular thing. Another recent change what we have done is, we have in the password change, we have included the special character. You should be knowing, every 120 days you have a compulsory password change to save you from misuse of your login. So use the special character, but do not start with a special character. You can use in between or at the end of the password. So this is a new thing, and we are getting plenty of queries from customers. I am unable to change password. I am typing this and this, but still not getting the password changed. So use a special character. That's compulsory now. Another common query what we have from users is, we have this daily alerts, Manu Patra desktop alerts, Manu Patra daily alerts. If you have registered for WhatsApp alerts, Telegram alerts, you have various options to get daily alerts. You have a desktop alert, Chrome alert. If you get a news alert and you want to search for that particular judgment, see, there are possibilities that's an interim order from a high court. Interim orders of high court are not covered in Manu Patra. If it's a final order, if a final judgment, it will be covered and you can search for it. So I have shown you an example. On 16th April 2020, there's a news alert, Supreme Court, gratuity payable on resignation from employment after 5 years of continuous service. So this alert has come to you. So I want to search for this query in Manu Patra. I click on the latest judgment. So you can see I have got Rajasthan State Road Transport Corporation versus Mohini Devi judgment, which is a 15th April judgment, and the news alert which came was on 16th of April. So this is the judgment which is covered in Manupatra. So if you search, you will get the results. If it is just a news alert and the judgment has not come out, you will not get the judgment in Manupatra. And this is the last slide. The most common mistake what users do is they close the browser instead of logging off from the sign off icon. Please sign off from the search Manupatra site instead of clicking on closing the browser. So do not do that. You might not be able to log in for the next 10 minutes. So avoid this. I understand everyone would be in a hurry to make searches. So do not do this mistake. Another colleague of you might be interested in logging in. So I thank you all for coming to this webinar series. These webinars would also be available in the YouTube channel. So you can view that there. I would be now having a Q&A session. If you have any questions, please raise your hand. Mr. Mittal?
Hello?
Mr. Mittal?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. So,
the question is with respect to asterisks, use of asterisks while searching in the legal search.
Yes. Use of asterisk is when you want to use for example, singular or plural, you can use it, or you can use two or three characters of the word and then put asterisk. It will search for all the other characters which come after that. So asterisk can be used in between the word, before the word or after the word, whatever way you want to use it.
All right. So another question I have is with respect to the judgment search, which you just told us that from the table of contents, if you say 2020 onwards, the judgment would not come like that. If, for example, I have to find out a judgment with respect to seat and venue arbitration, and I want only to see the recent judgments of that, how would I do that?
So one option is you do a search and click on sort by. There you have a chronological order sorting. So you get a latest judgments on the top.
But
that's one option.
Table of contents, no. I cannot find the recent judgments, isn't it?
No. This is one option. If you want only 2020 judgments of Supreme Court, go to
all the Supreme Court.
If you want all the judgments, then you have option only to sort it.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
And only for Supreme Court, then 2020 can be used.
Yeah. You can select as many years you want. You can also do it for all the high courts. You can click manually all high courts and click the latest year. But instead of doing that, you can do it on sort by, which is a easier option.
All right. And sometimes if you remember the name of the judge and we try finding out the judgment by the name of the judge.
Okay.
I don't know. It doesn't come like that.
No. If you have a particular judge name, we have a list of all the judges. You just start typing the name of the judge. You'll have a drop down. You just select that and you'll get the judgment.
Where do I find this? I only see it after I have made a search, then there's a window next to the table of contents where I see the name of the judges.
No. In legal search, you have an option to search by judge name.
Can you please show us an example?
See, when you log in, go to legal search, you have the judge name option here.
Okay, this I'm not talking about this. If you go to one search, so if you do it seat in menu search.
Okay, let me go to any of these search results, what I've done.
Yeah, sure.
See, this is a judgment search. If I open the judgment.
If you filter the results, this timeline, then you have filtered the results.
No, yes.
Please go back. Yes.
Yeah.
Then you filter the results. Can you? Yes, more. Then here you have the judge name.
Yes.
Can you see this? So sometimes I remember the name of the judge and a particular judge I'm looking for the search I've made. Can it be done here?
Yeah, it can be done here. This is one of the filters we have given for that purpose only.
I mean, I don't generally get a result after doing a judge search here.
No, see, you can try out the option from the legal search and then also do it. You can cross check that. You would surely get it. There is no possibility that you will not get it. You just check that. Cross-check that way, you will get the results.
Okay.
And if you have any queries, you can mail it on contact@manupatra.com. We'll help you.
All right.
Okay.
Yes,
Hello.
Hello. Yeah.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay. Good afternoon. I just wanted to know what is the relevance of using commas in the search results. When do you generally use commas? When you have multiple searches or.
Do not use commas in search results. Do not type paragraphs. You should only type the keywords as I showed you in the examples.
Okay. All right. And one more thing, when you explained about using, if I want the results for the latest, maybe for the year 2019, the filter result in, when you in this result page, that gives say particular for a period, say for 2010 and above. So if I want for a particular year, as I told you for 2019, what judgments on that particular research has been done? How do I get that?
See, one option, as I told you, you can select the table of contents. You can go and select the year there.
1 minute. I am just on that. 1 minute. Give me a minute. The table of contents is on your extreme left, right?
You can see my screen.
Yes.
See, I want judgments of 2020. I have selected this. Okay. One option is this.
Okay.
Second option is you do a search
I'm sorry. A table of contents gives you only the... Manupatra, Supreme Court, High Court and other. Where do I get the date icon on that?
Date? You want to search by date?
Yeah, as in I told you the year. Maybe 2019.
You have an option of filtering that in legal search. You have a date range option.
No, correct. So that is from 2010. That's giving me from 2010. But if I want for only 2019 or 2018, is that
possible? Have all years. You have all years. So you can see that all years are available. You can select any particular date.
No,
you can select from 2001 also.
How do I go there? I mean, see, I'm already on the filter result by, say, the period.
The next, you have a inverted triangle next to the search result.
1 minute.
Click on that.
1 minute, 1 minute. Inverted triangle.
Next to your search result, filters.
No, filters, yes. I have a timeline which there is. In the filters, I have the timeline.
Below the timeline period, you have a drop-down.
Drop-down, yes.
Yeah. Click on that, you have the other years available.
No, it doesn't come there.
No, so you can see my screen.
When it says display all, it says only 2010 and above.
No. You can see my screen.
Yes.
I am clicking on the triangle.
Yes.
I get the other years.
Okay.
You have this option.
2010. Okay. So.
I have all other years also. Only the first one, what you get is 2010 and above.
Yeah,
you have other years also there.
So I wanted for particularly for 19. So that is not available.
That is also there. No, you I just see 2019.
No. 2019. 2019. Not 1999.
Okay. 2019 is also available. Just click on the plus sign.
Okay.
Click on the plus sign.
Okay. All right. Okay. Got it. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Welcome. Yeah.
Thank you.
Mr. Raghav? Mr. Tadish? Hello.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Can you hear me?
Yeah. One second, one at a time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, can.
I'm Satish Rawal.
Yeah, Satish.
Actually, I've been, I'm very thankful to the way today you explained to me everything. It's very clear. I had a query which I made 2 days back. I wanted to search for one particular item called Section 2T, Settlement in Gujarat Stamp Act. I'm not able to find out anything from that. If the time is short now, you can give me a number, I'll call you afterwards. But my question is, under Section 2T, what is settlement, and under Gujarat? Hello?
Sir, I suggest you, please mail to your contact numbers to contact@manupatra.com. We will call you and solve your query. Okay?
I have already sent yesterday also. Sent yesterday. Again, I'll send it today.
Okay, fine. We will call you. We will surely call you today after this session. Okay?
Yeah, because 3-4 days I'm trying, but I'm not able to get
out of that. No issues.
Thank you very much.
We will help you out.
Yeah, I'll send my query again today.
Yeah, thanks a lot, sir. You can mute your mic, sir.
Hello.
Sir, am I audible?
Yeah, your voice is cracking. Yeah, tell me. Hello. Your voice is cracking.
Okay, so just give me a minute. Hello. Yes, sir. Is it better now?
Yeah, it's better. Tell me.
So actually, I just wanted to ask you one thing. Can you please readdress the green dot, which is the timeline authority? So what is the basic use of that?
So basically, see, you have got a relevant result. So from that, I want to see where all that particular judgment has been relied, where all it is dissented, where all it is mentioned, discussed, distinguished, affirmed. All that you can see in a single graph. And apart from that judgment, I can use some latest judgment where that judgment has been relied. See, it is always better in the court of law to use the latest judgment instead of referring the older judgment. So that graph will help you do that.
Okay, sir, and one more little issue. Sir, actually, I wanted to find a judgment. I actually found a judgment saying XYZ, but I wanted to find a judgment to the retrospective effect of that. So is there a shortcut or a thing that I can easily go through to find a retrospective effect of that?
So you can try the dissented, where that particular judgment has been dissented, that point is not accepted in that judgment, could be the reverse way, right? You have any queries, you can further mail it to contact@manupatra.com. We will call you and answer your queries, okay? Thank you. Please mute your mic after the...
Okay. I can surely...
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. So, what is your name, sir?
My name is Chandrasekhar Patil.
Yeah. So, I'll put your name when I'm putting my query on that. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Please unmute you, sir.
Yeah, I'll do that, sir.
Hello. Karan?
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, Karan, tell me.
Sir, I just have this one query. When you were explaining that instead of using long sentences, we should go for the specific words of what yes. we want to search for. So yeah. you just gave an example of like section 354 of IPC.
Yeah.
So when you search for that, so what you searched for was IPC section 354 bail grant. Mm. And there was a slash 20. So what was that particular thing, slash 20? And there was
that's a proximity search. So okay. I do not want IPC and 354 and bail granted to come in any paragraph of the judgment. I want it near each other. I want a relevancy to all these words what I've typed. So I did a proximity search, unordered proximity search in 20 words. So near each other. It will give you results. So how
can we add that proximity search?
In legal in Manu search, just below Manu search, you have near each other tab. You just click there. Automatically, it will take that query. You don't have to put in any quotes or any parameters.
Okay, sir.
If you want to change the parameters, you have an option in Manu search next to the search icon. There's a bulb icon. Click on that. That will give you the examples of how do you search on Manu search with these proximity parameters. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Mute your mic, Karan. Yes, Mr. Ali. Hello. Hello.
This meeting be available online?
Hello.
Yes, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. Will the recording of this meeting be available online?
Yes, it would be available in YouTube. You can search for webinars on Manupatra and you'll get this.
Okay, thank you very much. It has been very helpful.
Thanks, you're welcome. Please mute your mic, please.
How do I do that? Okay, hello.
On the left hand side, you have. Thank you. Please mute your mic, please. Everyone who has unmuted it. Do you have any other questions? You can mail it to us or leave in the Q&A session. We'll reply back to you. Thanks a lot for your time.